Students, can you see the slides? Students?
Ma'am.
Yeah, Sirisha, Chaitanya.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Kanastilla, ma'am.
Wait 1 second. Whose slide you want?
Student, no. Window. Application.
Iva kanastida Chaitanya and Sirisha? Chaitanya, Sirisha.
Ha, ma'am. Kanastide, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So shall I start with the class? Hello, Roshan.
Check, madam.
Yeah. Can you all hear me, students? Sirisha, Chaitanya, Roshan.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can you see the slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yesterday just I started with the rickettsial disease. So I'll just brush up what has been told yesterday, then I'll continue further. Just a second. So rickettsial disease are nothing but a group of diseases. It is nothing but a group of disease caused by the gram-negative coccobacilli. That means what? They are usually pleomorphic. They keep changing their form. Sometimes they look like cocci, sometimes they look like bacilli. So they are very small and gram-negative coccobacilli. And earlier they were put under the category of viruses, but now they are considered to be what? Bacteria itself. And they are totally obligate intracellular. So for their survival, they have to stay within the cells of the host. And very important is that the diseases that are caused by these rickets, rickettsial group of organisms, they need to be spread by fleas, lice, ticks, or mite. So these act as what? They act as the vector for the transmission of these rickettsial diseases. And very important is that structurally they have got three types of the antigens. So among these three types, one is group, another is species specific, but very important for us is alkali stable polysaccharide. So this is one very particular type of antigen, and which you have to remember it also. So based on this, the lab diagnosis can be made. So which creates what? Weyl-Felix reaction. So this particular antigen, it will be like similar to the antigen that is present in the Proteus bacteria. So the same Proteus organism, even it has got a similar type of antigen, so there will be cross reactivity. So whenever there is a cross reactivity, it will be seen in the form of a agglutination. So based on the results of the agglutination, we can diagnose that the person is having rickettsial or whether the clinical condition is non-rickettsial in nature. So this purely helps in the clinical diagnosis. Now already we have seen that the rickets is very much common among whom? It is common among the travelers. So MCQ can be asked related to this. And very important is that whenever the organism it bites, let it be tick, mite, or a flea, whatever it is, once it bites the host or the human, it will nearly take at least 1 to 2 weeks to show the clinical manifestation. So this point is very important. Sometimes, like nowadays, case-based presentation, they can say that after a tick bite or a louse bite or flea bite, after 1 week after the bite, the person has developed some of the clinical symptoms. So like based on this, we can say that, okay, it may be related to some rickettsial group of disease. And yesterday I already told you that this rickettsia, it contains a broad category of organisms. So we can broadly divide them under 4 genera. So each genera has got its own category of disease. So now pathogenesis, already I told you that it is mainly because of the causation of the vasculitis. This word is very important. Vasculitis. Because these rickettsial organisms, they have got more tendency or propensity, or they get more attracted towards the endothelium of the host. So there they go, and there they damage the host cells, leading to the leakage of the intracellular fluid. So that ultimately it results in the very aggravated clinical symptoms. So almost all the rickets cell group, they cause a similar type of clinical manifestation, but there are some striking differential features. Yes, maybe if this point is there, then it may be due to this particular organism. So it is like there are certain points based on which we can make a clinical diagnosis. Now there are various types of the rickets cell disease. One is the typhus group, another is spotted fever group, another is the scrub typhus. Different groups are there. In the typhus group itself, we have got different categories. So in that, three types are there. One is epidemic typhus. It is also called as classical typhus. Another one is Bril's incer disease. It is also nothing but the recurrence. Whenever this epidemic typhus, when it is totally completely treated, then what happens? There may be after sometimes whenever the host immunity is very poor, so that time there can be recurrence of the same typhus disease, but it is of milder in form. And next is the endemic typhus. It is also called as murine typhus. Now students, you have to remember that murine, this word itself says that it is caused basically because of what? Infestation of the rats. Because of the rats. So murine or the rats is one of the very important reservoir for this endemic or the murine typhus. So clinical features, almost all the typhus group have got a similar clinical feature. And this epidemic typhus, question can be asked, it is caused by what? It is caused by Rickettsia prowazekii. So this is the very important causative organism. And what is the vector? Because related to this, MCQ has been asked many times. So like, which is the organism or the arthropod that carries this particular Rickettsia prowazekii? What is that organism, students? Chaitanya, Sirisha and others? Students? Can you hear me? Jayashree?
Yes, ma'am.
Roshan? So what is the organism over here? It is nothing but the body louse. Sometimes head louse can also be causing this epidemic typhus. But very important is the body louse. So there are body louse, head louse and pubic louse. So among all that, the body louse is very important vector for this epidemic typhus. And especially very important, the fecal matter. Not by the bite. It is not by the bite. It is basically because of the fecal matter. So whenever this louse, it deposits its fecal matter. And when we scratch the fecal matter, that through that fecal matter, this particular rickettsial organism, it will enter the host body. So the internal invasion will happen mainly because of the fecus of the body loss. This point is very, very important. And incubation period is 1 week to 3 weeks, that is 5 to 21 days. And what is the case fatality rate if not treated? So it is 20 to 30%. What is case fatality rate, students? Students, Jayashree and others, it is nothing but tell Roshan. So out of the total people affected by the epidemic typhus, how many are being killed because of that?
Yes, ma'am.
So
it number is of case death fatality among the diseased person.
Very good. So it is out of 100 people affected, maybe 20 to 30 people will be killed because of this typhus. And it is very severe form of typhus. And clinically, what will be there? Usually fever, headache, myalgia. So these are all the classical features. And further, if it is progressed, it may lead to the mental confusion. So, or the clouding of consciousness, we can say. So this is the meaning of the word typhus. So what is the meaning of the word typhus? It is nothing but clouding of consciousness. So mentally, the person will be very much confused over there. And very important is the rash, because different types of typhus is there. So how do you clinically differentiate? Because case presentation can be for you. A male, adult male has come and complained that there was a body loss bite. And the patient has clinically shown what there are some rashes present everywhere on the body except for palms and soles. So this is very, very important differential diagnosis for this particular classic or epidemic typhus. So remember this point. Next, once if it is treated, then what will happen? The person will get recovered from this. And remember that for most of this rickettsial disease, what is the drug of choice, students?
doxycycline.
Very good.
Tetracycline.
Yeah, tetracycline or doxycycline, any of the alternate can be given. So doxy or the tetracycline can be a drug of choice for this particular typhus. And what is Brill's incers typhus or Brill's incers fever? What is this? It is nothing but the same epidemic typhus, and the causative agent is same. Rickettsia prowazekii. The person is totally cured or healed. Now, after so many years, there will be reoccurrence. So what will happen when the host immunity is suppressed? And even not required that there is a presence of body loss. In the absence of even body loss also, the patient may show the milder clinical symptoms like headache, myalgia, and the rash, which is a classical feature. And the person who is infected with this Brill's incers typhus or the fever, this fellow will be very much dangerous to the community because silently he can spread it to the many other healthy people. So this will result in what? Outbreak. So if the question is asked for you, like in the entrance exam, suddenly the person has complained of a mild rickettsial features and is nearing by people in that community are also showing this particular outbreak, similar type of clinical presentation, 5 to 6 cases are there in that community, then what might be the probable rickettsial diagnosis? So what you should answer, students, it is Brill's incers disease. Very, very important. And very important is the case fatality rate is low when compared to that of the epidemic typhus. Are you all clear, students? Satvik, yes, Jayashree? Okay, fine. Roshan? Next, the third form of the typhus fever. Very important. It is also called as murine typhus or the endemic typhus because related to this, many questions has been asked. It is caused by which one, students? R. Rickettsial typhi. It is caused by R. typhi. And what is the vector for this? The vector is nothing but, what is a vector? It is a rat flea. So it is nothing but a flea. So can you all see this rat flea over here? So it is body is something like it is compressed. So on both the sides, no. If you see the other type of tick or mite, how the body will be, it is flat actually. Whereas in this anterior, like dorsoventral, it is something compressed. So that is why how you can identify and say that it is a flea. And this flea, no, it can be present on the body of the rat or it can be present on the body of the cat also. Now, if the rat is infected with this R. typhi, remember this name R. typhi, it should be there in your mind. Endemic, murine. Murine means rat. Endemic means what? This particular fellow is localized to only one geographic area. It is not present everywhere. So one particular area, constantly, all the time it is present. That's why it is called as endemic typhus. So what is the source of spread or the reservoir? It is rat. So rat is the reservoir. And what is the vector, students? It is a rat flea. What is the scientific name for this? Xenopsylla cheopis. Very, very important. What is the name of this flea? It is Xenopsylla cheopis. Very important. Now this particular endemic typhus, it is very much endemic in the regions of Mexico. And this particular endemic typhus is also otherwise known as Rickettsia muceri. Muceri means mouse, mouse, mouse. Remember, wherever the mouse is there and on the body of the mouse. Can you see this picture, student? Students, can you all see this?
Yes, ma'am.
So on the body of this mouse, no, you can see so many organisms are sitting over there. So just looking at that, be careful. It is a red zone or the alert. Yes. Now there are chances that this area may get affected because the mouse is affected on body of this. What is present? The flea is present. Once the mouse is dead, then what will happen? The flea will come out of the body of the mouse and it will try to search for another alternate host. And if the man comes in contact, then he will also get this murine typhus or endemic typhus. Very important point, students. Remember this. Man is the accidental host. He is not the regular what person in this disease cycle. He is an accidental host. Accidentally, the flea will come in contact with the man and it will bite him and it will just pour or inject or inoculate this fellow with the Rickettsia typhi. So wherever man becomes accidental host, in such a case, there won't be human to human transmission. Remember this. This is very, very important point. Now, clinical features are mild. What are the clinical features? Again, it is headache, fever, myalgia. These are the general clinical features of this endemic typhus. Then very important is rash. Again, here also, the rash will occur anywhere in the body, but very important is initially the patient will say that, yes, I have got some rashes, especially it has seen on my trunk region. So this is very classical clinical presentation of the patient. Patient himself only will tell, I have got all this fear, problem, headache, myalgia and all. Along with that, after some days, I have noticed some rashes or spots on my body, especially in the trunk region. So truncal presentation of the rash is classical feature. Later it will spread to the periphery or the extremities of the body. Now this is all about the typhus fever. Typhus fever, how many types are there, students? Three types are there. What are they?
Three types.
Three types, very good. So what are they? Epidemic typhus. Another is epidemic typhus itself. It is Brill's incus fever or typhus. The third one is endemic typhus. Epidemic and the what Brill's incus, it is caused by which one, students? It is caused by Rickettsia prowazekii. Remember this. Prowazekii. Yes. What is the vector for that? Which is that small organism or the arthropod that is spreading this disease? It
is nothing but the
body louse. Remember, again, they may give you pubic louse or whether it is head louse. What is the louse? What is that louse? It is a body louse, which is basically causing. In that body louse, whether it is a bite or whether it is a fecal matter, students?
Fecal matter.
It is a fecal matter. It should be there in your mind. No bite, it is a fecal matter. Yes? Then the second type of the rickettsial disease is spotted fever. In this, many, many types are there. But for us, from our examination point of view, very few, I will explain it over here. One is Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever. RMSF. Another is rickettsial pox or pox. Then other types, it is like our Indian tick typhus. ITT, that is Indian tick typhus. And many other are there. Mediterranean tick fever or Mediterranean spotted fever, African, Siberian. So different varieties are there. But for our geographic locality and from our examination point of view, these three are important. Rocky Mountain, rickettsial pox and ITT. So let us see about these things in detail. So Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Actually, you know, this was first observed in the Rocky Mountains. Especially the organism that was causing this, it was wood tick. Tick means what? These are nothing but the arthropod or the small insects. Look at this insect. So what is the color of this insect, student? Can you tell me how it is looking? It is looking something like brown. Or red or orange. So this is the color of this particular tick. And this insect, it may reside in the wood. Big trees will be there, in between the trees, the crevice or the creases, this particular tick will be there. So it is caused by what? Rocky Mountain fever. It is caused by wood tick, or it is also caused by dog. In the dog, wherever the dog is there, so be careful. The dog also can transmit this particular disease. So the dog, if on the body of the dog, have you all seen these small organisms, students?
Yes, sir.
So these are nothing but the ticks actually. So if the tick, if we touch the pet, dog or whatever it is, so that tick, it may get into our body and it may bite it. And thing is that the dog also should be infected by this rickettsial organism. So what is the organism causing over here? It is Rickettsia rickettsii. So remember, Rocky, this fellow is caused by which one? RR. So it is triple R, that is Rickettsia rickettsii. Remember this. So if they ask you, Rickettsia prowazekii causes which one, students?
It causes epidemic typhus.
Very good, excellent. It causes epidemic. Brill's incus, again, same fellow. Prowazekii only it will cause. And endemic rat, it is caused by which one? It is caused by typhi. Rickettsia typhi rat. No, remember, students. Rat, R-A-T. In the rat, what is the word left in the end? That is T. So what is the organism? Rickettsia typhi. Typhi means this fellow is linked to murine typhus or endemic typhus, or it is a typhus that is caused from the rat. Rat acts as a reservoir. Whereas for our Rocky Mountain, it is caused by Rickettsia rickettsii. Remember this. Why I am stressing? Because so many questions are asked related to this. And clinically, it is very serious type if left untreated. And very important, students, very, very important, in all other type of typhus fever, what the patient was presenting, headache, fever, then what was there? Rash was there. But in Rocky Mountain, it is not the situation. in Rocky Mountain, first rash will start. First, what will start, student? Patient will complain of rash. After 4 to 5 days after the rash, then the patient will complain or will start showing fever, myalgia, headache, and many other clinical symptoms. And ultimately, it may lead to what? Pneumonia or meningitis, because there will be oozing out of the fluid. Because what is the clinical pathogenesis over here? Vasculitis. Because this fellow rickettsia, no, it has got full affinity towards the vascular tissue. It will damage it, and all the fluid that is present in vascular space, it will totally come out, and wherever the space is there, it will occupy, leading to clinical edema. Yes, students? So what is the differential point over here? The rash. Rash is the first thing that appears in the Rocky Mountain fever. And what is the vector over here? It is tick. And what is the scientific name of this tick? Ixodid tick. Remember this. It is Ixodid tick. It may be, this tick may be present on the dog, or it may be present on the wood. What is the other name for this Rocky Mountain fever, spotted fever, student? It is also called as
black measles.
Why it is called as black measles, student?
Rashes are black.
Yeah. Satvik, Akash, Roshan, Chaitanya, Sirisha, others. It is called as black measles because look at this picture over here. After some days, no, the rashes, they will turn into very black in color. Why black in color? Because it is nothing but the the blood which has leaked from the capillaries. So ultimately, as a consequence of it, as the days passes, it will turn into blackish in color. So that is why it is also called as what? Black measles. Now, what are the clinical features? The rash, now one more very important thing over here, students, the rash. In earlier things, the rash was not present on the palms or soles. Whereas in the Rocky Mountain spotted fever, the rash is classically seen on the palms and soles. Remember this. Can you see the picture over here, students?
Yes.
So we can see the rash on the palms and soles, and this same presentation can be seen in Indian tick typhus. In our India also, this type, a spotted fever is there. And if the patient complains of some rashes on the palm and soles, apart from the other parts of the body, then you can say that it is an Indian tick typhus. If it is outside the India, then we can say that it is Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Fine. Then apart from this, what might be the other clinical features? So what might be the other clinical features? It is eschar formation. Can you see the picture over here, students? Can you all see this clear picture? Look at here. The patient body, you know, you can see some necrotic area, and it is surrounded by some red color inflamed area. And what is this area? It is called as eschar. Eschar means what? It is nothing but ulcerated or the necrotic area. So these are the areas where the tick has bitten. Wherever the tick bites, you know, the individual. So at the site of the bite, at the site of the tick bite, what you can see? You can see what? You can see this particular type of rash or this particular type of necrotic area, which is called as what? Eschar. Now, students, you just remember and tell me, did we see this eschar in our typhus fever? Any of the typhus fever? Students?
No,
we didn't see any. Yeah. But now in the spotted fever, especially in the Rocky Mountain, so we are seeing the different type of clinical presentation. So how do you differentiate it from other type of typhus fever or the rickettsial disease? One thing,
excess.
Rash appears first. Rash is the first thing to appear. Second thing, rash classically, it appears in the palms and the palm and sole region. So this is one more feature. Yes, students? Are you all clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, and one more very important thing is that eschar formation. What is eschar formation? It is the site wherever the tick bites. So at the site of bite of the tick, you can see this necrotic or the ulcerated area. So this is what you need to remember it. Yes? Fine, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, this is all about the Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Now we will come to another type of spotted fever. So another type is what? Rickettsial pox. Again, related to this, many MCQ questions has been asked. So what is this rickettsial pox? Can you see the name pox over here? That means what? Its clinical presentation. Look at this picture. it mimics of that what? Chicken pox. It mimics that of what? Chicken pox. But how do we differentiate this? How do we differentiate this from the chicken pox? The thing is that the lesions are more superficial. The lesions are more superficial. And apart from that, the patient may say that I have got some bite over the body. Apart from that, you can also notice what? Eschar. What is eschar, students? Can you see it over here? Students? Can you all see the eschar over here? Yeah. So again, eschar is also seen in this rickettsial pox. So what are the clinical things over here? So one is eschar is seen and it mimics that of the pox. And what is the nature of the rash over here? It is vesicular rash. It is, can you see the vesicles over here? These are nothing but the something raised and something fluid filled. Yes, students? And these vesicles are more superficial and it mimics chicken pox. Now, one more important thing is that it is caused by what? It is caused by Rickettsia acari. This fellow is very, very important. It is caused by what? Rickettsial pox. It is caused by what? It is caused by Rickettsia acari. Just how to remember this. So many rickettsial are there. Rocky Mountain is caused by which one, students? Triple R. Remember that. That is Rickettsia rickettsii. It causes what? Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Then what about this pox? See, in the pox, no. So just remember this down extension. And you make it as A, small a. That means what? Just to remember. It is caused by Rickettsia acari. Now, very important is that how this fellow is transmitted. Again, it is linked to the rat. Wherever the rats are there, be careful. Rat is there means then definitely I may get endemic typhus or we may get rickettsial pox or many other types of diseases are there, rat spread diseases. Now, on top of this rat, mite will be there. On top of rat, what is present? Mite. So if on the body of the rat, if the mite is present, then if this mite, if it sucks the blood of this infected rat and this mite now it goes and bites the man, then what will happen? The man will get rickettsial pox. So rickettsial pox is spread by which vector, students? It is spread by mite.
Mite.
And what is the organism, student? It is caused by Rickettsia acari. Acari, what is the meaning of the word acari, students? It is nothing but the other name for mite. Mite is nothing but in term other way we call it as what? Acari. Mite is nothing but a insect. Yes? So what are the clinical features, students? Clinical feature is vesicular rash. Then after that, eschar formation along with that other fever and all can be seen. And it is a self-limiting disease. And it resembles to that of the chicken pox. Next, other spotted fever. Now, from the examination point of view, many types are there, Mediterranean, Kenyan, South African, African tick typhus. So all this, don't worry. But one thing I want to tell you is that Boutonnais or Mediterranean typhus fever, it is caused by which one? Because once question has been asked related to this. It is caused by R. coniri. It is caused by R. coniri. And what is the arthropod or the organism that is spreading this? It is tick. And it shows mild clinical features. So now, are you all clear with this, students? So we have seen that the rickettsial disease, different clinical presentation. One is typhus. Another is spotted fever. Typhus may again, how many types are there, students? Epidemic. Then Brilzinsers. Another is endemic typhus. Then in the spotted, we have seen different types, many types. One is Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Another is rickettsial pox. Another is Mediterranean fever. Another is Indian tick typhus. So these are very important from examination point of view. Next, another type of rickettsial disease is very important is scrub typhus. It is also called as bush typhus. Very important is that this particular scrub typhus, it is caused by which organism, student? Sirisha and others, Jayashree, Satvik and other newcomers, Roshan, Anirudh, Akarsh. So it is caused by Oriensha shushugamoshi. So this particular name itself says that this particular typhus fever has been noticed in Japan. First, it was noticed in Japan in the year 1930. So what is the organism that is causing this? It is Oriensia. What is the organism, students? It is caused by Oriensia shushigamashi. And very important is that, very, very important, it is also caused by mite. Look at this picture. This is an insect. But remember that this mite, no, adult form is there, then nymphal form is there, then larva. So different life cycle forms are there. So in this, very important is that the larva, look at this picture. This is the adult mite and this is the larva. So here adult, no, it doesn't bite. It doesn't bite the man. So the important is that this larva, it is also called as what? Chigger. It is also called as what? Chigger. Chigger. This particular mite, no, it is also called as chigger larva. So this particular larva, it will bite because the adult, no, it will remain silent and it will remain on the soil. That's it. Whereas this larva, no, it will go and it will bite the host, that is the man. Then we will get particular disease. So the question can be asked that scrub typhus is caused by which one? Adult mite or the baby mite or larva, whatever it is. So it is caused by which one, students? It is caused by the larva. Larva. This point you have to remember. And here also we can see the eschar. That is, at the site of the bite, what can be seen? We can see the ulcerated or the necrotic tissue can be seen. Apart from that, the patient also will be showing hepatomegaly and the splenomegaly. So these are the other clinical features. And very important is that why we call it a scrub typhus, because this particular typhus fever caused by the rickettsial organism is seen in the bushes. Can you see this picture, students? So the person who is working in this bushes or who walks in this farm area or the bushy areas, no, there this particular mite will be there, especially this larva, the baby ones. So when the baby contacts or bites this human, then chances that he may get this scrub typhus. So it is first seen in Japan. So geographically, it is still endemic to the regions of the Japan. Next, another type of rickettsial fever is which one, students? Q fever. What is the meaning of the word Q here, students? Query. That is question mark. So it is like when earlier, no, what happened? The patients used to complain of headache and pneumonia and fever, myalgia, many other clinical features. But the people, no, the, at that time, during the early 90s, they were not knowing what was this particular problem called to be and how it was caused by. What was the organism related to this? So that's why they have put the word as query fever. Because fever, still we don't know, it is a questionable mark of unknown origin. So that is why it is called as what? Q fever. And some other people says that first time this fever was observed in Queensland. It was observed in which one, students? It was observed in Queensland of Australia. So these are the probable reasons why it is called as still today as Q fever. And very important is that it is the only rickettsial disease. It is the only rickettsial disease where no vector is seen, where no vector is present. Because, no, in all the previous types of rickettsial disease, what we have seen, there was either body louse or tick or mite. Any of these were causing the spread of the disease. But whereas in the Q fever, no, there was no as such any tick, mite or louse. Then how it is spread? It is spread by the contaminated or the infected milk or by the dust or by the soil or by the aerosols. So these are the main what agents through which this particular Q fever will be caused. Then what is the organism over here? Students, Sirisha and others, can you tell me name of the
Coxiella
organism?
Coxiella Barnetti, ma'am.
Yeah, very good. It is caused by Coxiella Barnetti. So now what happens? Look at the picture over here. Sheep or maybe some cow or whatever is there. So when it is infected, when the man touches that while conducting the delivery of the sheep or cow, whatever it is, so whenever they touch it with the bare hand, then chances that with that touch itself, the person may get this Q fever. So the Coxiella Barnetti will enter the man and patient may get the disease. And very important is that here it will involve the multiple organs, leading to what? Pneumonia. Remember this, because related to this, many questions has been asked. So clinical features will be pneumonia. Then there may be meningitis, encephalitis, and hepatitis. So these are the classical features. And very, very one pathognomic clinical feature. So what pathognomic clinical feature? Can you all see the slide, students? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So very important is no rash.
No rash.
So rash is not seen because all other type of what rickettsial disease, like typhus fever or spotted fever, we were talking about rash. Rash will be seen and all. But here in Q fever, even though it is caused by what rickettsial group of disease only, I mean bacteria, but here no rash. And the causative mode of spread is also different over here. And clinically also, the patient will complain the features of pneumonia, respiratory distress and all will be there. Apart from that, the cerebral involvement and hepatic involvement will be there. Yes? Then other types of Q fever. So the Q fever, this Coxsackie Barnetiano, it can even cause acute Q fever or post-Q fever fatigue syndrome, or it may cause chronic Q fever with endocarditis. That means it may finally affect the heart tissue also. So this Coxsackie, it affects major organs of the body. So this is one of the very important clinical presentation of the Q fever. Yes? Now after Q fever, we will go to the trench fever. It is also caused by what? The rickettsial group itself. So what is the organism over here? Very, very important. Bartonella. It is caused by Bartonella quinta. Student, can you just switch off your microphone?
Okay, thank you.
Can you just switch off the microphone?
So remember, capsule is also very common nosocomial infection, like
in student.
Hospitals. Okay, and this can also reach the number of patients. That also need to remember. And an important finding here on the McConkie agar of capsule, we need to remember that. That is pretty.
So now the trench fever, it is caused by Bartonella quinta. Now quinta means what? 5 days. The quinta means what? The meaning is 5 days. That means what? Here in trench fever, the fever will be seen for 5 days. The fever will be seen for 5 days. And after 5 days, the fever may be repeated also. The relapse or the recurrence of the fever can be seen. So that's why the trench fever is also called as 5-day fever. What is the other name for the trench fever? It is also called as what? 5-day fever. And first time it was noticed in the World War I. And what is the vector for this trench fever? Again, it is the body louse. What is the scientific name for this body louse? It is Pediculus humanus corporis. Or simply we can say the Pediculus corporis. So it is a vector or the agent that causes this trench fever. And again, more than the bite, it is a fecal matter of this body louse. Can you all see the louse picture over here, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So this particular louse fecus, no, it will cause this trench fever. And it is also called as what? 5-day fever. Remember this. And there is no vertical transmission in the louse. Because you know, in earlier things, remember this, trans-ovarian transmission. That means what? If the louse or mite or tick is infected with the rickettsial organism, it can pass this rickettsia to its babies also. Once it lays the eggs, you know, within this eggs also, this rickettsia will be entering. That we call it as what? Trans-ovarian transmission. Whereas in the trench fever, this Bartonella quinta, it doesn't show any trans-ovarian transmission. So if the mother is infected, it is done. It can't transmit the what Bartonella organism to its eggs or its further generation. Now the clinical feature, like high fever will be there, headache, rash, and there may be recurrence of the this thing fever. Apart from that, the patient will complain of the bone pain, especially the shin pain. So the shin pain, and there may be neck, back pain, and endocarditis and lymphadenopathy. What is the drug of choice? Doxycycline. Another thing is not very much important over here. Just from your MCQ point of view. So Ehrlichia group, it is also rickettsial group of organism only. So it causes glandular fever. Now how it is caused? It is not caused by the tick, louse, or it is not caused by any aerosols or dust or mite. It is caused by the ingestion of what? by eating raw fish. So very important, this particular glandular fever, it is not an arthropod born, but it is caused by eating raw fish. Just remember this point, very very much enough for you. And other type of organisms are there, so which are caused by Amblyomma tick or Ixodes tick. So not very much important for you. So if required, you remember, otherwise you can ignore it also. So what is the treatment or drug of choice? It is what? Doxycycline. And sometimes we may add hydroxychloroquinone. So what happens, this hydroxychloroquinone, when we give along with doxycycline, then this doxycycline will be more effective against this coxsackie or other rickettsial organism. So hydroxychloroquinone, it will make the area more alkaline, and it will increase the effectiveness of doxycycline in killing this rickettsial organism. Now, I think like in the beginning itself, I told you about Weil-Felix test. Students, do you all remember this? What is this test? Students?
Ma'am, did you do polysaccharides? Yeah. Alkaline polysaccharides.
Yeah, very good. Now, what happens, no, in this rickettsial organism, there are different antigens are there. Now, in this, one particular antigen, that is alkali stable polysaccharide. This particular antigen, ASP. Now, this antigen, similar type of antigen is also present in non-motile proteus organism. Non-motile proteus organism. Now, what happens? When this particular antigen is present in both type of thing, there will be interaction or cross reaction, and it will lead to what? Agglutination. So whenever this agglutination happens, we say it as positive Weil-Felix reaction. Now here three types of antigens are there, OX19, next OX2 and OXK. So these are the three types of antigens that are present in the rickettsial organism, and it is also present in the proteus. Now OX19 and OX2, same type of antigen is present in proteus vulgaris, whereas OXK, this is present in proteus mirabilis. Just remember this. Now when, if you want to clinically laboratory, if you want to lab diagnosis, then epidemic typhus, it will show positive reaction for OX19 and OX2. That means if there is epidemic typhus, that is R. provazaki, then it will show agglutination with the antigen present in proteus vulgaris. So it is positive with respect to OX19 and OX2. And whereas endemic typhus, remember this, it also show positive reaction for OX19 and OX2. Why I'm stressing, just remember this. So epidemic typhus and endemic typhus, both of them will show positive reaction for OX19 and OX2, whereas it is negative for OXK. Whereas this scrub fever or the scrub typhus, this will show only positive with the OXK, that is OK. Scrub fever is OK or positive with the OXK antigen, whereas others will show negative for this OX19, OX2 and OXK. Now, we have come to know that even though it is positive with respect to epidemic typhus and endemic typhus, both are positive for 19 and OX2. Then how to further differentiate these two? Now, to differentiate these two, there is one more reaction, that is Neal-Moser's reaction. It is also called as what? Tunica reaction. Now, here what we'll do is like, we'll take the blood from the patient who is infected with the epidemic or endemic typhus. Students, can you all hear me? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
So then what we will do, we'll take the blood of the infected person, and then we will inject that blood intraperitoneally into the guinea pig. Then after some days, what we'll see the scrotal inflammation, so that the testis will be enlarged and it will lead to the adhesion. And it's such a adhesion is that we can't put back that particular testis back into the abdomen. So that we call it as what? Tunica reaction or Neal-Moser's reaction. Now, if the person is having endemic typhus means it is caused by R. typhi, rickettsia typhi. So if the person is having endemic typhus, he will show this particular positive Neil-Moses reaction. If at all the person is not showing positive Neil-Moser reaction, that means he is negative, that means he is showing the features of epidemic typhus, that is the organism is nothing but rickettsia provosacchi. Yes. Now we will solve some of the MCQs related to this rickettsial disease. The first question: which of the following type of the
ma'am doubt?
Yes.
Ma'am.
It is loud. Yeah. Which of the following type of the rickettsial disease insect vector is wrongly matched? Wrongly matched. Just this table, no, it is given in PARC textbook itself. This table should be there in your mind. You need to remember this. So epidemic typhus. So students, it's also called as what? Epidemic typhus. Look at the thing over here. Epidemic typhus is caused by what is the vector?
Provosacchi.
Body loss. This is correct.
Body loss.
Scrub typhus. It is caused by which one, students? Do you think scrub typhus is caused by flea? No. It is caused by the larvae. Bite of the larvae. So
mite.
This is very important. So this is wrong actually. Then again, Rocky Mountain spotted fever. It is caused by the Ichthyosis tick. So tick is correct. Then rickettsial pox. So pox is also caused by mite.
Mite.
So what is the answer? It is second one.
Second one.
Okay. Now we will go to the next MCQ. A patient complained of chills, fever, following a louse bite. Remember this. He is saying that I have got a bite from a louse 2 weeks before. After that, he had rashes all over the body and was delirious at the time of presentation to the hospital and subsequently went into coma. So what, mentally he is confused. So that itself indicates that it is a typhus type of disease, because louse bite and he has gone into coma. Now a provisional diagnosis of vasculitis due to rickettsial infection was made, because we already know that is the reason why I told about the pathogenesis, because this organism has got full affinity towards the vascular tissue. And which one of the following can be the causative agent? Now students, you only tell me.
Provosacchi.
Yeah, it is provosacchi. Do you all agree with this, other students?
Yes, ma'am.
Chaitanya and other students, Sirisha. So it is caused by rickettsia provosacchi, because this provosacchi, you know, what is the vector for this? It is body louse. Whereas the other rickettsial organism, louse is not the vector. Fine. Next. Mode of transmission of Q fever. How is this Q fever transmitted? Now you people only should answer for this. How it is transmitted? Sachin and others, Jayashree, Satvik. How it is transmitted, Roshan? So yeah, it is Q fever. No, we already said that there is no arthropod or the insect involved in this. It is transmitted due to consuming of infected milk.
Dust,
or aerosols. Now just look at the options. Anyone is inhalation. Matching with this? Third one.
Inhalation of aerosols.
Inhalation of the aerosols. So third one is the right option for this. Next. A man presents with fever, chills 2 weeks after a louse bite. There was a maculopapular rash on the trunk which spread peripherally. The cause of the infection can be. Now again, you have to look at the point over here. There is a louse bite. Yes.
Epidemic typhus.
Yeah. It is caused by which one?
Epidemic typhus.
It is caused by epidemic typhus. Whereas other type of the options given over here, all these are caused by which one? They are caused by ticks and mites. So only one given over here, which is caused by louse, is epidemic typhus. Next. All of the following statement are true regarding Q fever except. So regarding Q fever, all are correct except. It is a zoonotic infection. Do you all agree? It is correct actually. Because if the sheep is infected or cow is infected, we may get this.
No, ma'am.
Then human disease is characterized by interstitial pneumonia. Do you all agree with this? Does it cause pneumonia, Q fever?
Yes, ma'am.
Students?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So it is also correct. And no rash is seen.
Yes, correct.
So this is also correct, no? In Q fever, rash is not seen. Then the Weill-Felix reaction, it is useful for diagnosis? No.
No.
It is not the very classical thing that can be used for diagnosis. So what is the option over here? It is the fourth one. Next. All are true about scrub typhus except. Now in the scrub typhus, everything is true except. So what is that? It is caused by the bite of the what?
Mite.
Mite. That is especially the larvae. So this point you have to remember. It is correct. The second option you see. Adult mite, it feeds on the vertebral host. Do you think adult mite it will feed? No.
No.
It doesn't feed on anybody. It will live by itself like that. Yeah, third one is also correct. It is caused by R. suzugameshi. Then tetracycline is the treatment of choice. It is also correct. Now, what is the answer, students?
Second
one. Adult mite feeds on vertebral host. Next. Rickettsia, rickettsia, that is RR. RR, it causes which one? Now you should only tell. RR, it causes Rocky Mountain.
Rocky Mountain spotted fever.
Do you all agree with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now which one causes Indian tick typhus, ITT? Now look at the table here. Indian tick typhus is caused by R. coli. Very, very important. Then, Rickettsial pox is caused by R. acari. Acari, what do you mean by the meaning of the word acari?
Mite.
Mite, mice, acari. Yes. So what is the answer over here? It is
Rocky Mountain spotted fever.
Now, rickettsia are transmitted by which of the following? So look at the options over here. It is a group of disease transmitted by flea. Do you all agree with this? Flea transmits which type of rickettsial disease?
Type B.
Students, endemic or murine typhus. So, this is important. And louse. It transmits which one, students? Epidemic typhus.
Prowazekii.
It is caused by rickettsia prowazekii. Or it may cause Brill Zinser fever. Or it even causes which one? Trench fever. So this point you have to remember. Mite. Mite causes Atari. Which one, students?
Acari and scrub.
Scrub typhus.
Very good. Scrub typhus and all. Very good. So now all these are the agents or the vectors that causes rickettsia. Then what about mosquito, fly and all? No. Fly, yesterday we have read about the fly, right? House fly, it causes? Trachoma. It acts as an agent in spreading this thing. Then again, mosquito, no? So different types are there. Like Aedes mosquito, then malaria, and then filariasis. All these are mosquito-borne. So in the next sessions, we'll continue with this mosquito-related. So what is the answer over here? Flea, louse, and mite.
Mite.
So tick for all these three. Next. Quintin fever is caused by? Students, can you tell me quintin fever is caused by which one?
Coxsackie.
Yeah, it is also the other name for which one? Trench fever.
Q fever.
No, not this thing. Quintina fever. Quintal. Quintal means what? Five, right? It is the other name for this thing.
Bad.
Yeah. Quintina fever, trench fever, all these are one and the same actually. It is caused by Coxsackie Burnetii. So remember this. It is spread by which one? Again, fecal matter of the body, louse. Remember this. Q fever, what is the meaning of the word Q over here? It is not quintin, it is query. Remember this. Or Queensland. Remember this. Don't get confused. Quintin, it is number 5. It is also 5 days fever or trench fever. It is caused by fecal matter of the body louse and organism involved is Coxsackie Burnetii. Remember this. coxiella. If you complete this C, it will form Q. It is nothing but Quinton fever. Yes, students, are you all clear with this? Any doubts? Students?
No, ma'am.
Fine. Next question. True about trench fever or all except? Again, the question is asked about except. Now, trench fever, we know that it's also called as spider fever. And then, very important is that trench fever, it is caused by, again, what, students? It is caused by Coxiella burnetii.
Coxiella burnetii.
And it is also caused by body louse. What is the scientific name? Pediculus corporis. And treatment is doxycycline. We already know this.
Doxycycline.
Now, looking, knowing these these facts, you people only now tell me what might be the probable answer for this.
Trench
fever, all are true except. So, caused by Coxiella burnetii, correct? Is it a 7-day fever or 5-day fever?
5-day fever.
So, definitely second option is wrong over here. So, we will keep this in our mind. And it is caused by pediculus corporis. Nothing but body louse. It is also correct. And doxycycline is the drug of choice. Everything is correct. So, what is wrong over here? Second one. So, your answer should be which one, students? Second one. Yes? Now, rickettsial pox is caused by pox. If you don't remember, what is the thing I told you to remember is P,
Akari.
Word P, just rub off this extended downline. It is caused by Akari. It is caused by Rickettsia Akari. Yes? Are you all clear, students? So, Rickettsial pox is caused by Rickettsial Akari. Conori is the one that causes Indian tick typhus. Then R typhi, it causes again
typhus.
Endemic typhus or murine typhus.
Endemic.
R rickettsia, again RR. Why I am repeating everything again, that you should not make any mistakes when you opt for the answer. It is again Rocky Mountain spotted.
Rocky Mountain.
Okay. So what is the answer? Rickettsia akari. Yes, next. Endemic typhus is transmitted by which one? Endemic typhus. So it is transmitted by which one, students?
Flea. Flea.
It is transmitted by flea. Very good, excellent answer. So typhus means what? Rat flea. Or it is also called as what? Murine typhus. Murine means rat only. So it is caused by the bite of the rat flea. So don't get confused. Flea is there? Fine. My answer is correct. Yes? Next question. Weill-Felix reaction positive for protease strain OK, OXK is seen with. So what did I tell? Scrub typhus. OK.
Scrub typhus.
Yes?
Scrub typhus.
It is scrub typhus only. So
yes,
scrub typhus, in the Weill-Felix reaction, if the antigen or the protease antigen agglutination happens with OXK, OK. So then it is nothing but positive for scrub typhus. Whereas in epidemic and endemic typhus, which will be positive? OX. Which one, students? OX2 and OX. Which one? Just see this. OX19 and OX2. Remember this.
OX2.
To differentiate between endemic and epidemic typhus, which test has to be done? It is or Neal-Moser's reaction. Just remember this. To differentiate between these two, this is a diagnostic test. And to differentiate clinically, I mean laboratory, if you want to differentiate for scrub typhus, then go ahead with this WF reaction where OXK is positive. Yes, this is all about the rickettsial disease. Now, last one for today is Zika. Disease or which is caused by Zika virus. Now it is caused by which one? Again, arthropod borne virus, that is arbovirus, and this Zika virus. Why it is named as a Zika virus, students?
Discovered in Zika, ma'am.
Yeah, very good. It was first discovered in the year 1947 in the Zika forest of Uganda. So, in the African area, Uganda, in the particular Zika forest, it was first seen in the monkey. So the forest organisms, no, like in the forest species, this particular disease was noticed, and then they have identified this particular organism and they named it as Zika virus. And to which family it belongs to? It belongs to the same family which causes yellow fever, Japanese encephalitis, and even dengue. So what is the name of that family? It is Flaviviridae. And it is a single-stranded positive sense RNA virus. And what is the vector for this? Very important, Aedes aegypti and even Aedes albopictus. Same vector which even causes chikungunya and dengue fever. So it is the same vector that even causes the Zika disease. Now, one more thing about Aedes aegypti is this particular mosquito, it is also called as what? Students, it is also called as tiger mosquito. Why it is called as tiger mosquito? Students, can you see its body? White stripes you can see everywhere. Yes, you can see. So that is the reason which gives white stripes and resembles the stripes of the tiger. So that's why it is also called as what? Tiger mosquito. So vector, if they ask you, what are the two vectors? Aegypti and Albopictus. Now, geographically, not very much important for you. Just for your point of knowledge, you have to remember this. So it was first noticed in 1947 in Uganda, in the monkeys. Then gradually it was seen in 1960s in Nigeria. Then it was seen in 1970s in India. This is very important. So in India, we noticed somewhere in 60s and 70s. Then in 2007, in the island of the Yap, this particular Zika virus was seen. Then 2014, very, very important. So during this year, WHO has said that it is a global emergency. Because in Brazil, South America, most of these parts of South America, it has suddenly shown an outbreak, a boom, an outburst was seen. So that's what WHO said, that it's a year of global emergency for this Zika virus spread. Now, very important is that this particular Zika virus, it is highly infective. That means what? If one fellow is infected today, he may spread it to many other people. So that is, the spread will be very quick, and that's why it may lead to the pandemic. So chance of pandemic is very high with this Zika virus. Then how it is spread? Because MCQs are asked related to this. It is spread by mosquito. What is a mosquito? Aedes aegypti or Aedes Albopictus. There can be vertical transmission, that is from mother to child spread can be there, and it may spread due to blood transfusion, that is infected blood, or even during organ transplantation, or due to fertility treatment. So in the semen or whatever is there, during that part also treatment, it may spread, or during sexual contact. So these are all the different modes this Zika virus may spread. And very important is that this virus, it will remain in the semen for a longer time than in the blood. Very important point. Then clinically, the very important striking features are that mild headache, and especially the patient will complain that retroocular headache. That means I have got a pain just behind my eyeballs. So this is one of the clinical feature. And patient may complain of mild fever, rash, myalgia, and arthralgia, that is joint pain, especially small joints. And sometimes along with the joint pain, you can see the swollen joints. And very, very important classical diagnostic feature of Zika fever or Zika virus fever, along with the other clinical feature, is conjunctivitis, that is red eye, painful, or the red eye. It is a very important diagnostic feature of this Zika fever. And post fever or post Zika infection, the patient may complain of weakness, and all these symptoms will persist of how many days? 3 to 7 days. So what is the clinical diagnostic feature? It is the red eye or the conjunctivitis, apart from the arthralgia, fever, headache, and other features. Now, what is the treatment for Zika virus? Students, it is just a symptomatic treatment. We can give just a paracetamol. Don't give aspirin, because what happens if you give aspirin? Students, what will happen? It may lead to further worsening of the situation. because what will happen, the patient may show the bleeding symptoms. Apart from that, we can give the fluids and ask the patient to take the adequate rest. Then how do you protect the further or prevention of the Zika virus? What are the various modes of prevention? Like mosquito protection and avoid the sexual contact if the person is already infected. And how do you do the mosquito protection? Ask the person to wear the long sleeve or make sure that the body surface or the areas wherever mosquito bites, no, let it not be exposed. That is, wear long sleeve clothing and use the mosquito net or mosquito repellents. And there is no vaccine for this Zika virus because yellow fever, dengue and all, we have already got the vaccines for that. Whereas in Zika fever, we don't have any vaccines. Now, students, very important, this point you have to remember, there is a vertical transmission. So pregnant lady, if she is infected, then the fetus may get damaged or infected with the Zika virus. Now, in 2015, in Brazil, they have observed that many children born to a mother infected with Zika virus with microcephaly. Very, very, very important clinical feature. Remember this. So what is the clinical feature? Microcephaly. You need to remember that. So in Brazil, so most of the babies who are born to the mother infected with the Zika virus showed which one? Microcephaly. So it is finally, it shows many other clinical features termed it as congenital Zika syndrome. So what all you can see in the congenital Zika syndrome? Students, you people only read the slide and answer it. It is microcephaly, decreased brain growth or damage of the brain or cerebral tissue, seizures, and damage to the eye tissue and limited range of the joint movements. The baby's body joints, it cannot move it freely and there will be stiff muscles. Apart from that, if not all this, then there may be preterm birth or there may be miscarriage. So these are all the different things that can happen if a pregnant lady is affected. Now, if the mother is infected or the lady is pregnant and if she is positive for the Zika virus, then she has to consult her concerned specialist person and the person may ask to go for amniocentesis to check if the fetus is infected or not. And some more points is that lactation is considered to be safe because even if the mother is infected, the mother can safely go ahead with the breastfeeding. So breastfeeding is encouraged rather than asking to stop for the feeding. Then what are the complications with the Zika virus infection? So most of the complications are neurological complications. So what are these complications? One is Guillain-Barré syndrome, neuropathy and myelitis. So these are the possible neurological complications caused by Zika virus. Now let us solve some of the MCQs related to Zika infection. Which of the following is true about Zika? Students,
vertical transmission. See.
Vertical transmission is correct. Then it is caused by human to human contact? No. Because it is an arthropod born. You need a mosquito or something.
Bite.
Then Zika vaccine is available. Do you think vaccine is available? No. It is caused by mite. It is also wrong. What is the answer over here?
Vertical transmission.
Next. Which of the following is most common congenital defect caused by Zika? What is the most common congenital
Microcephaly.
So spherocytosis is wrong. Microcephaly, very good. It is correct. It is one of the confirming features. Agnathia and all of the above, these two are not the options. So your answer should be second one. Next. The Zika virus was first discovered in the Zika forest in Africa. Read the question. Since then, it surfaced in several other regions of the world. Aside from mosquito bite in the regions where virus is present, how is Zika spread? Now the question is related to the mode of spread of Zika. So
all of the above.
Everyone, do you agree with this? Because we know that sexual contact also helps in the spread of Zika virus. It is correct. Then it can be transmitted from mother to baby. Vertical transmission, true. Through blood transmission or organ transmission also, it can spread. So now all of the above is the right answer for this Zika virus. Do you all agree with this, students? Others? Do you all agree with this? Roshan and others? Satvik, Sirisha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, why do emerging disease or emerging virus like Zika continue to plague on us? Why, like already we know that in 1947 it was seen. Now again it is re-emerging, right? Now again outbreaks are seen in 2014 in Brazil and many babies were infected. Why all these are happening again now? So what might be the cause over here? What is the reason for this emergence of Zika virus? Read the option. These virus mutate and hence re-emerge. Do you think it is because of the mutation? No. The virus has remained like that only. Next one. We disturb forest where they quietly exist as zoonosis. Remember, that is the reason why I have told you about the historical aspect. Because in 1947, in the Zika forest of Uganda, first time this Zika virus was isolated from monkey. Right? It was actually seen in monkey, which was present in the forest. Now we are causing deforestation. We are disturbing the forest. Now the monkey has come out of the forest and it started biting the man or getting contaminated, or the mosquito has bitten the monkey which has come to the urban area, and that's why it is spreading. So we disturb the forest, that's why it is causing the disease. Do you agree with the second point? Students, do you agree with this?
Yes, ma'am.
This is correct actually. So that is the reason knowing the history is also very important to answer the MCQ. If you answer them correctly, definitely you can crack your seat to the best branches whichever you are choosing it for. Then mosquito are the main culprit to encourage the widespread virus spread. Fine, this is also correct. But very important is that the second option. Yes? So the answer which you need to choose over here is the B1. So this is all about the today's MCQ and the discussion for this. I hope I have covered everything related to rickettsial disease and even related to the Zika disease. So students, you just go through your textbooks and even the MCQ books and solve the questions. Everything is covered over there. And one more thing I want to tell you is that in rickettsial only, I mean other than rickettsial, the vagabond disease, one question has been asked. It is caused by tick, mice, louse, or flea, whatever it is. It is caused by which one, students? Roshan, Satvik, Sachin, Akash, Chaitanya, anybody? Sirisha, Anirudh. So it is caused by which one? Vagabond disease is caused by body louse. It is nothing but a dermatitis actually. This pedicular scorporis, no, the louse. Other than causing rickettsial disease, it causes many other diseases. It can cause even skin or dermatitis where the skin area will be thickened because of its repeated bites. So it is called as what? Vagabond disease. So vagabond disease is caused by which one, students? It is caused by
body
Chaitanya, louse. Yes, Roshan. It is caused by body louse. So I will stop it today and I will continue with the other communicable disease in rest of the classes. And tomorrow there will be ophthal class. Dr. Pinto, he will be taking it on cornea. So all of you kindly attend the ophthal class tomorrow at 9 o'clock, and we will send the link for that. And one more thing I want to announce is that shortly our Dr. Lakshmi will be taking the upcoming classes on anatomy lecture, and Dr. Ravish, he will be taking on biochemistry lectures, and kindly attend these lectures and take the benefit of this. And Dr. Veenawari, she will be taking a lecture on pediatrics. So even attend Dr. Veenawari's lecture on the pediatrics so that you will get a complete knowledge on all these subjects. Okay, students. So shall we disperse?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.